NSSF members to earn 9.65% interest. Innovation Village and ICT Association of Uganda sign MOU. FITSPA to celebrate milestones reached in 5 years. Kenya exports first goods under AFCT. And Saudi remittances to Kenya double to $187 million amidst maids abuse. So a few more days and September will be done. And for a business person, we probably think you have goals that you set for, let's say, 3 or 6 months. And when you sit back and you look into the goals, are you staying on track, or there are several things that are not working? We know for a fact that most businesses are now settling into the times, we're talking economic times, which seem unpredictable, but some of them are actually making money out of the tough times. My name is Simon. Thank you so much for joining us on The Business Show this week. Here is what you can expect.
A record is a summary of events and transactions in our day-to-day life.
Once again, welcome to the show. Now, for years, SACCOs have been seen as a reliable platform for savings. And we know for a fact that growing up, most of our parents will tell you they're in some group at least where they put money and they can also get that money whenever there was need. But listen, as technology evolves, there's been a lot that has happened with the SACCOs. And this week we are speaking M-SACCOs, and this is a platform that has been created by FeatureLink. And this platform allows these guys under their SACCOs not only save but also access their money whenever they please at a moderate rate as well. And like I keep saying, if a business person or any other person that wants to use your money, if the money you're taking is at a higher rate, then you might never make sense of it. In Views from the Top this week, we speak to the CEO of FeatureLink, who shares with us some of the milestones they have attained and also tells us just how fintech is changing the face of business in Uganda.
Hello, my name is Vincent Tumwejuche, CEO and co-founder of FeatureLink Technologies. FeatureLink Technologies is licensed by the Central Bank of Uganda as a national payment system operator. We are a community-driven marketplace for affordable financial services. What that means is that we enable the end consumer to access varied options of financial services provided by a network, a big network of SACCOs that we are working with, and help them to choose the most appropriate and affordable financial services. And also for the SACCOs, you know, the SACCOs come to us because we are the platform through which they are able to acquire remote customers, mobilize savings and grow transaction revenues and serve the customers at 10% the ordinary cost. It's something that we are really proud of, and we think that for a long time, Africa being a fragmented society, but also Uganda, you know, fragmented around tribes, fragmented around culture, there have been lots of financial services, but which really do not appeal to the customer. And we believe that the many people that are still excluded from the financial services is because the services that are available are not appropriate for each community. They are so generic, okay? And then they are so expensive. So we solve the problem of exclusivity the inappropriateness of the financial services by allowing the SACCOs themselves, community cooperatives, to design their own financial services and then give them the platform to scale those services. You know, Africa is really gifted. We have the Ubuntu. 7 out of 100 people in Africa belong to a cooperative, and that includes children and the elderly. We, because of the Ubuntu culture, we still have influence, peer influence. And so when you build services around this peer influence, you are able to get ownership of everything that comes out. Now, the model of SACCOs is that the customer is also the owner. And that for me and for us at FutureLink becomes a very important element in economic transformation, because then the people are able to sit down. They are able to say, we want loans that are going to be given out at this rate. And that interest that you pay eventually comes back to you as a form, in the form of a dividend. And so you have money that is able to remain within the communities. If you work through SACCOs, the money remains in the communities. The interest that you get from the people eventually remains in the community in terms of being able to be lent to someone else and also being paid out in form of dividends. So that way you do not have economic transfer from rural to urban. So this for us is really a very important aspect, and this is why we chose to actually work with SACCOs. We see this as phenomenal, really phenomenal. Why do we see this as phenomenal? No, because we are beginning to see this as an empowerment of the end consumer to be able to make an informed choice. Think about the fact that what we enable the end consumer is basically, first of all, to access and then the power to choose. For a long time, you have not had anyone being able to choose their financial services. When you go to a bank, you will only get the services offered by that particular bank. When you go to a particular SACCO, you will perhaps get a brochure that, you know, gives you a list of services and their charges. On MSACCO, however, you are able to get all these services on one page, and you can right there make a choice and say, okay, looking at this and looking at that, I think this will best serve me. So we see MSACCO as a financial freedom, as a tool for financial freedom. And this is actually the tagline, financial freedom in your hands. And this is what we are really pushing. So MSACCO is truly a tool for financial freedom. Yeah. MSACCO has been designed to recognize the unique setup of our communities. So you have, and by community we're not talking about just geographical communities, but we are talking about communities in terms of purpose. Communities in terms of, for example, you can have teachers. Teachers are spread all over the country. You can talk about farmers. Farmers are not in one area. So you have, we understand farmers to include also the people who are involved in the value chain. My relatives who may be in Isinjo have bananas, but these bananas transported to Kalerwe, they have other people that actually receive these bananas. So it's a community around purpose. Now, this needs to be enabled. MSACO enables such a community to be able to remain close in terms of financial services, that the one who actually digs in the farm and the one who actually receives the produce are able to remain within the same community, because then the data we are able to use the data to actually score, develop some credit scoring and saying, this one pays so and so, and so they are not as risky as you think. They deserve credit at a lower cost, because you know their information. What has been happening is that this farmer does not have a financial card. He doesn't have a financial card, no one knows about him, and so it becomes difficult for them to actually access credit. So that is the number one. So how does someone get to start their journey? For an ordinary user, we have profiled about 300 SACOs on MSACO. So if you are an ordinary user, you can just download the app on Play Store and be able to sign out. It's just a few things. You just need to have your national ID. You will take a picture of yourself. It's a very simple process, and there then you can choose which SACO can best serve you. Whether you are in the north, you are coming from the north or east or central or western, there are SACOs that can actually serve you. But if you are a SACO, how do you actually get on board? Then we start with automating your entire process. You know, you have processes, we deploy a core banking system in your premises, we manage the entire infrastructure, and then having automated you, we are able to bring you to the people who are able to actually join you. So it's a marketplace. So we bring the providers of financial services, which are the SACOs and microfinance institutions, and then we also bring the ordinary person to be able to choose which of them can actually best serve them.
Great stuff there, and we just thought we could have a two-part series of this conversation, because we did sit down with Vincent and he speaks about several stuff, very important points that you as a business person should look through, and more so on how leveraging on technology could help your business move forward, but also access to finance through technology has been deemed the most safer way to go. And in part two of Views from the Top, we'll be looking at how the recent regulation by Bank of Uganda is creating hope for the fintech industry that is growing at, I must say, a real faster rate, despite the challenges of, fraud and the others. But there is hope. All this will be worked on. Let's take a quick break. We'll see you shortly.